Bangkok is home to two massive airports that handle millions of travelers every year. They're connected by highways, railways, and shuttle buses, making it super easy to travel from. But here's a question that literally no one has ever asked. What's in between the airports, and is it possible to walk from one to the other in a single day? Well, pay attention. The answer is yes. I am currently filming a secret and highly controversial documentary whilst training for the biggest walk of next year. Chiang Mai to Bangkok. It's 25 days of pure walking. We've already raised over $400 for the little doggos of Thailand. It's going to truly be a one-of-a-kind video series that will be truly epic. Unless I die. Then it probably won't be that good. But for now, enjoy this little Brucey bonus, a 17-hour walk from me and Mike. We're always trying to give you an alternative style of YouTube content.
Good morning, everyone. And for anyone watching this right now, wherever you are in the world, I hope you're having a great day. And if you're not, tell someone about it, as it'll help. Yet another sub 5 a.m. start, but it was actually nice to experience the rain for a change, a quick walk down a few BTS stops to meet up with Mike and flag down a taxi to the airport. Now, I've never got to an airport just to turn around and leave it before, and anyone who knows Bangkok knows that it's not the easiest of places to get to, and it certainly wasn't the easiest to walk out from either. But we arrived there feeling fresh and full of energy, super busy even before 5 a.m, and as Mike was appearing on the channel for the first time, I wanted us to have an interesting and pretty unique experience.
Okay, we're at Suvarnabhumi, title card. Okay, we're at the airport.
We turned our back to this airport and headed out. It was so nice to have someone else holding the camera for a change, so I can see just how badly I need to go on a diet from all angles. We knew it wasn't going to be easy to escape an airport on foot. I mean, who does that really? But I thought we had found a way through the maze by walking through this car park. It was way too early to be cheating on 7-Eleven, and look how amazing this is. How many times does the beauty of an airport go unnoticed? The lights, the architecture, the fact that we're the only tourist around. It was super cool in my book. But what wasn't super cool was everything else that happened next. So many dead ends, many restricted access areas, we couldn't figure a way out, and we ended up walking around for 1 hour before we just decided, screw it, we'll walk down this pretty busy motorway. It was pretty dark, pretty dangerous. Sometimes a path would appear and sometimes it would disappear. But after a quick bit of uncertainty, we had indeed successfully found our exit. Life hacks with Walker. Try to ensure to get your feet soaking wet at the beginning of an epic walk. That way, in about 10 hours, you'll get trench foot and you're practically guaranteed a week off work. Leave your thank you comments down below. I didn't notice, but Mike mentioned that I was already limping, and given that I've already walked 250 kilometers for this channel in about 6 weeks, probably explains it. But no need to worry about that, it's super early in the morning, so you know what time it is.
7-Eleven.
Only kidding, they didn't serve coffee, so we had to make do with that. A pineapple-topped pizza slice, don't send in your hate letters just yet, and some glorious plane footage. I then took a few minutes to film this shot without noticing the missing floor to my side.
You guys remember when health and safety was a thing?
But then it was back onto the road, and onwards to the next life-affirming visual wonder for you all to enjoy. Or 7-Eleven, whichever comes first. We managed to completely miss this elevated bike path, so it gave me the chance to play with my camera some more. Now, I know the English are famous for complaining about the weather, but so far, due to the morning storm, the sun hadn't actually come out yet, so it has been super refreshing. We reached another dead end, leaving us with little choice but to jog over this bridge. Luckily, I have a lot of experiences to share with Mike about bridges. I mean, it's pretty similar to just walking over the flat, to be honest. Again, still not 100% sure if we could walk over. Google Maps said we could, plus I did see a jogger coming the other way. But other than getting off the bridge, it was all pretty straightforward.
Go, 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 go! Oh, oh!
It was only when I started to mess around with the camera again that I found the most amazing discovery.
Okay, I've got some absolutely amazing news. Mike, your t-shirt's inside out.
Yeah, your shirt is bright green.
Yeah, fair point.
Latte, yeah. You won.
I won.
Okay. I won.
Okay. I won.
Song Dao.
Okay.
7-Eleven coffee. I was going to make a joke about being unemployed, but it's not working. Hashtag, what are you doing? I'm the star. 7-Eleven coffee. Last night, my wife told me to stop pretending to be a flamingo. I had to put my foot down.
The weather is perfect. It's nice and cloudy. Absolutely beautiful day. Reminds me of being back home in England.
We crossed over the road, up some stairs, and I finally felt like I was moving towards nature. But first, I had to answer a call of nature of my own. I was pretty desperate at this point, and this was my only option. With no lights and only mosquitoes to keep myself company, well, the less said about that experience, the better. But at least Mike had the chance to dress himself properly.
You fixed your t-shirt then, Mike?
Yep.
Nature was indeed calling. The sun really started increasing the temperature, so it was time to unleash my brand new super sexy hat. We continued walking, I was enjoying the fresh air, and I was informed politely that I hadn't removed the price tag. Well played, Mike. 1-1 at dressing correctly. We reached this super epic crossing. I had noticed the train go by just before, and us being English, we filled in a risk assessment form, put medical services on standby, and then just said, screw it, let's run across. This path, alongside a klong, or river, or stream, I don't know, nature, was very unique and beautiful, but it was about to get a lot more dangerous.
Okay, so we've decided that we're going to try and cross this bridge, but apparently I'm going first because I'm the heaviest. How is that logic? Luckily, if I do fall in, I'm holding a camera. Oh my God, it's also really wobbly. Oh, this is terrifying. Terrifying, look at this. Oh my God, these look thinner than the last pieces.
Will our plucky adventurers make it? Find out right now. Of course we did. I just wanted to call myself plucky. In fact, we ended up walking for about 5 more minutes, came to another dead end, and had to turn back around and go back over the bridge again anyway. We pressed on, seemingly a never-ending path, taking in as much as we could and the occasional stupid joke.
Hey Mike, I was gonna try and wear my camo trousers for this one. I couldn't find them.
Always on the lookout for any potential dangers, but we finally did get to the end of the path, hit this bridge so we could turn towards civilization. The
sun's finally came out and absolutely destroying us both. I think we've got 20 minutes before we're not allowed to buy alcohol anymore, so that's the next mission. I haven't seen him run like that since the last time we had a curry and the toilet was a kilometer away.
I'm pretty sure I mentioned how long this road was. Like really long. Like really, really long. Wait, let me look up another adjective. Categorically long. But we still had enough energy for another bridge, messed around with the camera a little bit more, and then we continued down this alley towards this park. I got to take some really awesome footage of some flowers, but at this point we'd been on our feet for nearly 10 hours, so it was just fantastic to sit down.
Amazing park, just met that guy, Craig, really cool guy. Lots of turtles, monitor lizards here. We've done all the sort of difficult part now, it's just mostly a straight line for the rest, and we'll see what else we can find on it. Speaking of straight, I mean, I thought I'd try myself a Smirnoff Ice pink, because, you know, that's what a straight man with his nails painted does.
We found this ball and proceeded to see who could dive down the slider the best with it, I'm pretty sure Mike won, before getting up a bit of a sweat leaving the park. Back onto the highway, the sweat was literally dripping off of us. I added some suntan on my leg to ensure the bright colours remained bright throughout the many years of regret I'm sure to have ahead of me. Speaking of legs, what the hell is that? Well, if you don't see Mike in the next episode, we know why. And onwards to our next location, which is a sort of a closed floating market. It was actually kind of cool to be there when it was closed so there wasn't anyone around, leaving us to explore and enjoy the shade. But then we noticed these absolute units.
Yeah, they walk about the same speed as Mike. Have you heard about our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ?
Hello.
Wow, you have heard of him.
We quoted multiple Bible verses in an attempt to get him to speak again, but they all failed, so we went outside and Mike took the opportunity to take this amazing shot, so I took the opportunity to ruin it. Further ahead, we reached this bridge and Mike took the opportunity to take this amazing shot, and I once again somehow ruined that too. On the bridge, I could see a man feeding the fish, so I ran back down, hurriedly moving these rats with wings out of the way so I could film the fish eating. Now, I know my camera is waterproof, but you never know, so I wasn't planning on dipping it in, but I could hear a faint music coming from below, and to my surprise, underneath the murky waters of this random floating market was actually the entrance to the lost city of Atlantis. For thousands of years, people have been searching for this, and it was 30 kilometers north of Bangkok the whole time. Who knew? 3.5 hours that joke took. What am I doing with my life? To make up for all of the shots that I'd ruined earlier, I took this for Mike, and then I was simply happy not to be the only cool man wearing green at the market. This really was a very cool, traditional place, complete with temples, rich culture, history, and of course, dinosaurs. At this point, why the hell not? We rejoin our walking heroes, heading purposely in the wrong direction to the airport, stopping only to take in some important sights before continuing along and getting towards the shopping center called Big C. Not much of interest here. Mike wanted to change his shirt, but he wouldn't let me get a new one. I managed to splash some water on my face, try on a pair of shoes that were too small, and then we hit the road again for another 90 minutes to get to Safari World. The plan was to use the 3-meter tripod I'd been carrying the whole day to get you guys some awesome footage of some animals, but ultimately all we got was this guy fishing, a golfing range, and a pack of dogs.
We're in a pretty unique position. We've managed to get to an airport today only to turn around and walk out. We've managed to walk to Safari World only to walk past it. And now we're heading to another airport only to turn around and walk out again.
We were starting to figure out why walking airport to airport wasn't on TripAdvisor.
Hello, sawadee kap.
Two lovely ladies and a fantastic beer stop later, Mike was truly discovering what a day with Walker was all about. What other Monday afternoon could two best friends who had been walking for nearly 13 hours in a major city get to take in these sights? Nature was all around us and we were enjoying Thailand's many perks, quirks, and whatever the hell this is. We sobered up on the main long road towards the northern part of Don Mueang Airport. We used the restrooms and headed into this park. The light was going down, we could literally see the planes landing in the not so far distance, and our spirits were super high knowing that this near 15 hour walk was coming to an end. But little did we know how wrong we were.
We can see the planes landing, they're just the other side of this fence. We're so close, Mike, we can do this, let's go.
Our optimism turned to despair. There was no exit. Google Maps were wrong, and we were out of time.
Come on, Mike, we have to go. We have to go, let's go.
We had walked for 15 hours over 50 kilometers and our journey was coming to an end 500 meters from the airport.
So we just got stopped by this lovely lady who saw us walking around the park completely lost. And apparently we're not allowed to go through the park, is that right?
Yeah. You can't.
Yeah.
It's impossible to walk there?
You have to walk, like, around.
Okay, well, Mike has an iPhone. It works better at night, so we're going to walk around here. Finish the video, finish the job, and go home and sleep. And what was your name?
Sanook.
Sorry?
Sanook.
Sanook.
Like snooker.
Oh, yeah. Snooker. Snooker, all right. And yeah, we got to end this on a high. We got to find a plane, and then we can go home.
Inspired by the kindness of strangers, we decided to finish what we had started. Even if we couldn't film it how we wanted, 90 minutes later, we found ourselves outside Don Mueang Airport. 58 kilometers walked, 4 a.m. had turned into 9 p.m. According to my Fitbit, I had burnt over 8,000 active calories, so it was really hard to see why I am so fat, as all I had eaten was 3 pizza slices, 4 chocolate bars, 2 big plates of noodles, and like 6 big bottles of... Oh.
Hey Mike, I got an idea. You know the next time we go to an airport?
Yeah.
We should get a plane.
That thing.
All that remained to do now was pop outside, get on whatever the first bus was, and try and sit as far away from the bus driver as possible so he didn't pass out from our smell.